Say this. You think that you've got it all designed your way. You think that you've accomplished something that no one else on the face of this earth's been able to do. I should have been wrestling the Georgia heavyweight champion. That's what my contract read. But the state of Georgia and Georgia Championship Wrestling has saw fit to deny the National Wrestling Alliance, to deny the world's heavyweight champion, and throw me in against a man of whoever they want. Wrestling number two. Well, let me tell you something, too. Two is one higher than one. I happen to be number one, buddy, right there. This is Mr. Wrestling number one. It says world's heavyweight champion. There's no two connected with it. And I'll guarantee you, when I get done, there damn well ain't gonna be two connected with it then.
Handle, but you've been on an intensive training regimen, and you appear to be in the greatest shape of your life.
Well, I've never felt better, needless to say. But, you know, I like to back up just a little bit, and, you know, Austin Idol, he can claim to be whatever he wants to be. But the facts of it is that it did take three men to beat me. He can deny it. He can say whatever he wants to say. But the facts is, it's all, everyone saw it. Everyone knows that Austin Idol is a fake. He's a phony. Just like the time that he made that phone call and made me go out and said that he beat me in the middle of the ring. Austin Idol, you have never seen the day that you could beat me by yourself. I'm much more the man than you'll ever be. You know, and thanks to Georgia Championship Wrestling. They made it all possible because they're tired of taking anything from anybody. They're standing on their own two feet, and they got it done. They made it possible for me to wrestle the world's heavyweight champion.
And that'll happen tomorrow night at the Omni.
Omni, tomorrow night, Harley Race. Let me tell you something right now. It's not going to take three men to beat you because I'm going to do it by myself. I'm going to do it all alone. There's not going to be any interference because there are going to be three men down there to make sure everything goes right. The world's heavyweight champion, three of them are going to be there. I'm going to promise each and every one of you out there, and I don't make promises, I will be the winner.
The battling Bostonian Kevin Sullivan and Tony Atlas.
Well, Gordon, you know, a lot of people have been out here and they've talked about it, and they've talked what they're going to do and how they're going to do it. You know, everybody since Tony and I have gotten together have been behind us and supported us. Just recently, one of Tony's idols, Jesse Owens, died. That man accomplished more for this country than any athlete before this time. He showed the world and he showed Hitler, a man that put down this country, what it was all about. And I'm proud to have Tony as my partner, and more than that, we're proud to represent the people here.
You know, Smirnoff and Koloff, they did a whole lot of talking, and now they got Raskin here doing a whole lot of bad mouth and talking about they don't have no athletes over here in the United States. Well, you let me tell you something, brother. I think the best athletes in the world is right here in the United States, because the people here in the United States, they're going to have to go out and work 8-hour jobs. They got to worry about their family and everything. They don't have no support unless you get a sponsor and you go over to the Olympics. But over there in other countries, they get paid for whatever they do. If you're a wrestler, you get paid for wrestling. You're a weightlifter, you get paid for weightlifting. So you let me tell you something, Russian, German, all of you, y'all got the belt. You may be champions now, but the time is coming. Every dog has a day. What goes around comes around. You reap what you sow. The time has come.
And that time is tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night, y'all gonna be beltless. The USA, we have the belts back. We coming after the belts. We gonna get the belt. You gonna reap what you sow. Me and my main man, Kevin Sullivan, is coming to the Omni.
Gordon, I just want to make this really clear. We've never promised the people anything, but we're promising everybody out there and everybody in the studio, tomorrow night, the Russians are gonna lose those belts to two Americans. They're out.
This tag team event will be one fall with a TV time limit. Introducing first from Japan, weighing in at 240 pounds, Tenryu. His partner from San Diego, California, weighing in at 240 pounds, Snake Brown. Their opponents from Roanoke, Virginia, weighing in at 250 pounds, Mr. USA, Tony Atlas. From Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 230 pounds, the Boston Battler, Kevin Sullivan.
Kevin Sullivan and Tony Atlas going up against Snake Brown and Tenryu. And this match has some international implication to it. Tenryu, of course, from Japan. The battling Bostonian, Kevin Sullivan. Good shoulder smash by Sullivan. Sullivan up and over on Tenryu. Tenryu, good block by Sullivan. Into a reversal, into a hip lock takedown. Tenryu gets a head scissors. Sullivan breaks away from it. Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, in there delivering some punishment to Tenryu. Tenryu bags up with the Snake Brown. And Snake Brown driven to the canvas by this extremely powerful Mr. USA, Tony Atlas. Picked up by the crowd once again here at the Television Sports Arena. USA, USA. This wave of patriotism sweeping the nation today is certainly an inspiring thing indeed. Andrew caught by Kevin Sullivan. Good arm drag takedown once again. Whether you're in Sanford, Florida, or Minneapolis, Minnesota, Poughkeepsie, New York, or San Francisco, California, if you get a chance to see live wrestling, we suggest you do so. It's tremendously exciting here on television, but much more exciting when you can see it live. Snake Brown driven to the canvas by Tony Atlas. Atlas drives him into Kevin Sullivan's boot, and Brown in trouble now. Kevin Sullivan, a snapmare that takes Brown to the canvas. And Sullivan planted both feet firmly into the stomach of Snake Brown. Nice to have a group here today from Harper High. And some other folks here from Porterdale. Nice to have them here in the studios. Tony Atlas, wide stance now. Feed on the hammerlock, partial hammerlock on Snake Brown, keeping him on the canvas. And time may be winding down for the world heavyweight champion, Harley Race. Snake Brown suddenly turning on Atlas here, getting to score more effectively. Atlas in those ropes, taking a lot of punishment from Brown. Atlas now unleashes with two solid right hands. Brown caught with a flying drop kick, and that one almost tore his head off. Tag is made. Kevin Sullivan moves in. Sullivan, short chopping forearm into a lateral press. Brown powers out before the count of three. Tenryu moves into the ring. Kevin Sullivan, Tenryu chops across the chest. Snapmare on Tenryu. Tag is made with Mr. USA blocked. The arm drag takedown blocked very nicely by Sullivan. Mr. USA Tony Atlas moves in. Tenryu drives the knee to the midsection. Tony Atlas circling his man, closes in once again, collar and elbow. Atlas uncorks one to the midsection. High drop kick by Tony Atlas puts Snake Brown back to the canvas. Tenryu charges in, and it's Tony Atlas catching him now. Atlas being caught from behind. Now we've got all four of them in the ring at the same time.
Seattle, a standing flying dropkick by Tony Atlas. Snake Brown coming off the ropes. Atlas catches him. Brown trying desperately to block it. Atlas scores with a full body slam. Atlas crashes down across his chest. Well, there you have it, an outstanding victory for Tony Atlas and Kevin Sullivan. Let's kind of review what we've seen here today on Georgia Championship Wrestling. First of all, I think we have unraveled the situation regarding Tommy Rich and his quest for the World Heavyweight Championship and the dangers of wrestling on television because of the compacted time on television. The danger involved there, Tommy Rich had his chance at the World Heavyweight Championship, went for the television championship, subsequently was injured and lost his chance for the world title. Now, of course, Tommy has one thing in mind and one thing only, and that's to settle the score once and for all for the man who cost him that title shot, Austin Idol. What's your name?
Sonia.
Sonia, and where are you from, Sonia?
Stone Mountain.
Stone Mountain. What's your name?
Terry.
And where are you from, Terry?
Decatur.
Decatur. Okay, and you, young man?
Skip.
Okay, Skip, where are you from?
Dorville.
Where?
Norcross. Norcross.
Oh, okay, fine. I'll accept that as an answer. You know, there's no problem there. A fine group of youngsters, and Kevin, it is inspiring to see these youngsters feel so strongly as they do about the USA.
Well, goodness, what Tony and I have talked about, we have people that support us, and this is the backbone of our country. And I, you know, growing up, people have always talked about the young children of today. I couldn't think of a better group of people right here, Georgia and all around the United States, and they support us. And what's the word?
USA!
This is why those Russians don't have a chance against us.
Well,
they belong to us.
Well, of course, he's referring to the Georgia Tag Team Champions, and may I just say, too, that I, too, am very heartened to see these youngsters with this great fervor. As I said earlier, this great wave of patriotism sweeping the United States. Certainly, this is something that all of us need to take into consideration during these extremely troubled times. Our time is completely gone for this hour of Georgia Championship Wrestling from Atlanta, Georgia, USA. So long.
Thanks for watching Georgia Championship Wrestling. The announcers on this program were employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling Incorporated. Join us next time for more action and excitement. The top wrestlers in the world today on Georgia Championship Wrestling.
He gave me the name Wi-Fi, and he told me, he said, I give you that because you take care of business. Idol, for 4 weeks, 5 weeks, I've laid up. I've run every day. I've pushed the weights. I'm in better shape than I've ever been in my life. You better hope you're in shape because somewhere down the road, you know, I'm just waiting. When I get my chance with you, Idol, that's when it's all going to happen. You know, it's been building, and it's finally coming to a head. Idol and me, and Idol. When it's all over with, I'm going to walk out on top. You know, you was talking about my mother a while ago, you know, out here talking about that. You bring in family and you say what you want about me, but you don't talk about my mother, you know. You don't talk about none of my family. So, Idol, I got a whole lot of reasons to want you.
Well, tomorrow night you've got that chance.
And that's exactly what I'm going to do. Tomorrow night at the Omni, Idol, I'm going to be down signing autographs a little early so I can see all of my people. And then after it's all over with, I'm going to meet you right in the ring. And it ain't going to be no sneaking in behind somebody, Idol. It's going to be you and myself. And I'm coming at you with everything I got, Idol. I'm coming to hurt you. You hurt me. I'm going to let you see what it's like to lay up for 4 or 5 weeks and realize what you've got and what you've lost. Idol, it's Omni tomorrow night, brother. I'm coming to take care of business.
It's the Easter
Two movement will be one with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Russia, the combined weight of 520 pounds, the Georgia Tag Team Champions, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff and Alexis Smirnoff. Koloff and Smirnoff, the Georgia Tag Team Champions. They're accompanied by their manager, Rock Hunter. Their opponents from Atlanta, weighing in at 215 pounds, Gerald Finley. His partner weighing in at 220 pounds, the Scorpion.
All right, and so the Russians are bringing their flag out. Gerald Finley moving against Ivan Koloff. Henley moves in and inside. Cradle tried to hook him in, but Koloff now suddenly exploding on Finley. Finley, of course, went to Harper High School. He was an outstanding football player. 1969, he was on the All-City team and made All-American in 1972. Finley backing away, tags up with a Scorpion. The Scorpion moves in. And the Scorpion giving Smirnoff everything that he can handle at the moment. Rock Hunter hurtling instructions to them. There you see Hunter watching very carefully. He has them tagging in and tagging out with great regularity. You know, Ted Oates was talking about Ole Anderson. Ole Anderson's a man who just doesn't know the meaning of the word quit. It's not in his system at all to quit. He suffered the consequences of that when he was injured by these Russians and has not wrestled in the state of Georgia since that time. Ole Anderson also has the memory of an elephant, and I'm sure he's not forgotten these Russians. Again, you see that double teaming by the Russians, but well within the four count. All right, the tag is made. And there you see him break it just before the four and gets out of the way. This enables, it gives them about 3.5 seconds where they're able to abuse their opponent even more. Fast tagging in and out. Great teamwork between these two. So the Scorpion has been unable to get back over to that corner and tag. He is conceding. He concedes on that hammerlock. And so another team falls victim to the Georgia Tag Team Champions, Ivan Koloff and Alexis Smirnoff. And Mr. Rock Hunter has joined me here and obviously very pleased.
Well, Sully, you know, I think one point should be made very clear. You're probably wondering about the display of nationalism. Well, it seems that there's been a great many displays of nationalism recently, and I think that it's time that we're allowed at least to, the Russians are allowed to express their sense of national pride.
Well, in the true American spirit, that is permissible, yes, sir.
Another point I'd like to make is that with a finely honed, well-conditioned, extremely knowledgeable, brilliant team like the Russians, we haven't got to worry about any opponent, pair of opponents, threes, fours, any combination of opponents you'd like to throw at this great team from Russia. Well, we welcome the challenge. We've had a great many, I would say, very difficult tests. But we have another test coming up very shortly.
Tomorrow night, as a matter of fact.
As a matter of fact, in the Omni. Now, this is probably, in the eyes of a great many people, our greatest test yet. The team of Tony Atlas and Kevin Sullivan in the Omni. Well, I'll tell you this right now, Tony Atlas and Kevin Sullivan, you've never faced anything like the team of the great Iron Russians. And I, Rock Hunter, guarantee that either Kevin Sullivan or Tony Atlas will submit with our hammerlock.
We'll find out tomorrow night at the Omni. Kevin Sullivan, a dynamite tag team combination.
Well, thank you, Gordon. You know, I was out here a little while ago, and I was listening to the Russians, and I listened to Rock Hunter, and he let something slip. He says, we're going to show some nationalism. I thought the man was an American. And if you're an American, you're supposed to be proud of this country. The man is nothing but a lowlife. And I heard them say they're going to put a hammerlock on me and Tony and make us submit. Well, I'm going to tell you one thing. You could break our arms off, and we're not going to give up to any Russians.
Well, you know, I listen to him out here talk about putting hammerlocks and everything on people and going to break people up. Well, you let me tell you something, Rock Hunter. You look at that two men right now that have worked hard to get to where they are now. You look at that two men that if you just rip my arms out of the socket, I still ain't going to give up. And if you think you could break these two arms, they're two pretty good arms here, brother. If you think you could do anything with either one of them, you just bring them two big old German egg-headed scanners on, because we got something for them.
Well, tomorrow night at the Omni, of course, the Georgia Tag Team Championship on the line.
You know, Gordon, I never promised anything that I couldn't accomplish. And I have a man here, and I promised the people before, and I promised the people at home. Right now, I'm going on my word that if Tony and I don't win, we're leaving.
We're winning.
We're winning.
We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning. We're winning
Griffin.
There's nothing to be afraid of, because if we didn't win, I couldn't show my face, and I guarantee the people next week on TV, Tony Atlas and myself are going to be the new champions.
This match will be one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first from Germany, weighing in at 285 pounds, Baron von Raschke. Baron von Raschke. His opponent from Jacksonville, Florida, weighing in at 215 pounds, Mike Davis. Mike Davis.
Mike Davis going up against Baron von Raschke. And Davis ducking away. Von Raschke trying to get his hands on it. Davis finally meets him head on. Von Raschke with an arm drag takedown, but Davis on his feet very quickly. And it's Von Raschke going into a single leg Boston Crab. And Davis has got himself some problems now. And into the ropes, the referee calls for the break. And Davis has some real problems with that leg. Von Raschke closes in again. Continues to punish his man. Now Davis exploding on the side of the head of Von Raschke. Von Raschke took the best Davis had to offer. And Davis hurtled outside the ring. On that cool, hard concrete. Mike Davis trying gamely to come back to his feet. Forearm across the chest on Mike Davis. Von Raschke, another clubbing forearm. Davis starts to move toward the ring. Von Raschke brings him in. Full body slam. Now, planting a foot in the chest. Davis smashed into the turnbuckle and down. Davis has a world of hurt on him right now. Davis caught in a rear chin lock by Baron von Raschke. Davis brought into those ropes by von Raschke, and von Raschke utilizing the ropes. Again, von Raschke closing in. Overhooking and underhooking the head, and so Davis has had his breathing very, very seriously impaired. And von Raschke goes with a claw. Von Raschke closes in with the brain claw. And that's interesting to know, too. I want to ask him about that. He has him out. He has him out. Baron von Raschke using the brain claw very effectively on Mike Davis. Interesting to note. See if I can get Baron von Raschke over here for just a moment. His hand appears to be completely well. Yet last week, when he came into that situation with Wrestling 2 in the Georgia Heavyweight Championship, his hand was taped up. I noticed your hand is not taped today, sir. How come?
They have all been warned. They know the power of the claw. And all the gutless Americanish wrestlers are hiding behind the promoters. They have formed a wall, a brick wall, to protect them. They do not accept my challenges. Well, I have ways to deal with them. The cartel that sponsors me is not afraid of the power of the promoter. I will get my matches, even if I have to go to extreme, extreme measures to provoke the so-called best Americanish wrestlers to step in the ring with the great Baron von Raschke, master of the brain claw. They all tremble in their boots. They see my wrestling superiority. And just that makes them afraid. And with the power of the claw, I am superior. I am unbeatable. And the promoter is right to protect them. Because when they step in the ring, they will all go down to defeat.
Yeah, well, thank you very much, Baron. I appreciate the comments, and I do have a couple of other things I need to talk about at this time. I noticed we never did get an answer regarding why he had a taped fist last week and does not have a tape.
I had a plan.
Yes, okay, sir.
And you have just seen the beginning of the master plan, the final solution for you Americanischer wrestlers like number two, Tommy Rich, Tony Atlas, Kevin Sullivan, Valu McDaniels, Dusty Rhodes. Line up and face the Baron in the final.
Thank you so very much, Baron Von Raschke.
Southern Heavyweight Championship, and Bad Bad Leroy Brown has vowed and determined, as well as his manager, a gentleman that I can only say is as evil a man as I've ever known, Sir Oliver Humperdinck. They have claimed that they are going to regain the title, and right now, here are some very personal comments from Bad Bad Leroy Brown.
I got my traveling clothes on because I'm on the road. And I'm on the road of a dirty dog by the name of Dusty Rhodes. And I'm going to chase him down like a dirty dog that it is. If I have to go all over the South, New Orleans, Mississippi, even in the state of Georgia. Like I told you once before, I'm going to be like Sherman, march to the sea. Because I want what's mine, brother. And what's mine is mine. I weigh 325 pounds. If you ever saw a man 325 pounds upset, let me tell you, it's a sight to see. And Dusty Rhodes, you the cause of it. And I'm going to follow you and I'm going to catch you, brother, because I got my traveling clothes on. And when I get you, brother, you're going to hear the sound of the whistle. You're going to hear it, and you're going to hear it wherever it is. Tomorrow night in Atlanta, Georgia, in the Omni, it all come to pass, brother. It all come true. You signed the contract to meet the biggest man in wrestling today. And I'm going to take what's mine, brother. And I'm going to do anything it takes to get it. So beware, because it might take place in the parking lot. Dusty Rhodes, you belong to me.
We're going to be hearing some comments in just a couple of moments from the Southern Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, Dusty Rhodes himself, Stardust himself, the most charismatic wrestler that I think I've ever seen compete. Dusty, of course, at one time the World Heavyweight Champion, along with another great Texan out of West Texas State, Dory Funk Jr. Of course, as you know, Dory Funk Jr. was fined $2,500 for some of his actions recently, and of course Terry Funk is still under a 30-day nationwide suspension by the NWA. All three of those men are from West Texas State. But right now, let's listen to the words of the Southern Heavyweight Champion, Dusty Rhodes.
Bells are ringing all over the southern states, Mississippi, Louisiana, Georgia, Tennessee, Florida, all the great southern states, the great southern champion. The bells are ringing for me and my guy. My guy's Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, the Southern Heavyweight Champion, the last great warrior, the last great modern-day hero, the last warrior of our time, the man that knows more about pain than anybody, the man that dishes it out more than anybody, Southern Heavyweight Champion, ex-World Heavyweight Champion, only man never defeated, actually pinned by Harley Race. Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, gonna be in all them citizen states in Alexandria, Hawaii, all over the world, bringing this thing to you. Ringing bells, the bells are ringing. That reminds me of whistles blowing. Just recently, right away, I heard this man. And so tomorrow night in the Omni, Bad Leroy Brown and Oliver Humperdinck, when he's blowing his whistle, Gonna be wounded of me talking about the Southern Tower. I'm gonna be ringing his bell, and the bell I'm gonna be ringing is his noggin. Tomorrow night, and I'm that bad Leroy Brown, Sir Oliver Humperdinck, you are in the big time. My Southern Tower goes on the line, and I'm gonna stick that whistle. Woo, where the sun don't shine.
Oh, that is Idolmania. This is what everybody is talking about everywhere in the country. Austin Idol for president, and I will be president. And when I do become president, do you know who I'm going to have driving my limousine, chauffeuring me to and from the Oval Office? It will be none other than himself, Tommy the Chauffeur Rich. Tommy the Chauffeur Rich, you'll be the one who will drive the Idol to and from the big seat in the big city. You're looking at it right here. You know, Georgia Championship Wrestling has overruled the National Wrestling Alliance. That tells me one thing, that they want the whole world, and they don't care about anybody else but Georgia Championship Wrestling, and that they want the entire country. Well, they can have it, but they better remember one damn thing, that the Idol is the nucleus of this country. 8 million homes, darling. 8 million homes. Three people to a home. 24 million people tune in every week to see the prettiest, the sexiest, the most intelligent, the greatest all-around athlete of all time, the Georgia champion, and I should be having this shot for the world's title. I'm the world's champion.
Thank
I'm the
so
world's
much.
Champion right there.
Thank you so very much. We'll be right back. It is the dream, the culmination of any man's career.
Well, I think it is. You know, and I, once again, I've got to thank Georgia Champ Wrestling for the accomplishing all this. Because, as you know, they overruled the NWA and made it very clear to everyone that was involved with that that everything is going to be taken care of, but they're not going to put up with any more shenanigans or backstabbing or people getting in people's way. And it, you know, I also made a statement not too long ago that wrestling, too, has always stood his ground. Wrestling, too, has never given up. Wrestling, too, has never backed away from any one individual. And I also made a statement that I promised a lot of people. And I'm telling you right now, believe what I say. I don't make statements that I can't back up. I never have. And I want everyone to know that what I've said in the past and the promises I've made in the past, I'm going to hold those promises, and I'm going to keep each and every one of them, and each one of you out there, believe me, and depend on it, because I will back up everything I've said.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Wrestling Number 2. Time now for our final match, so let's turn it over to our ring announcer.
This match will be one fall with a TV time limit. Introducing first from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 235 pounds, Charlie Fulton. His opponent from Hamilton, Ontario, weighing in at 285 pounds, Iron Mike Sharp. Mike Sharp.
Iron Mike Sharp moving out against Charlie Fulton. This is our first time to see Mike Sharp in action here in Iron Mike on Georgia Championship Wrestling. However, I know he's been campaigning throughout much of the South. He's been given accolades by several states. He had an outstanding high school and collegiate career in football, also in boxing, and all forms of one-on-one competition. And, well, we're seeing some evidence of it right here. Fulton coming out of that head scissors, however. Single leg pickup by Iron Mike. And into a toe hold by Iron Mike. Good wide stance. Wrenching that leg and putting on additional pressure. He's into the ropes. Referee calls for the break. And Fulton having some problems now with that leg. Close in once again, collar and elbow. It's Fulton that time getting the move on Iron Mike. Iron Mike, a beautiful reversal, has Fulton to the canvas. Big man, some 280 pounds. And extremely well proportioned, as you could see. Powerful legs, powerful upper torso. Snapmare. takes his man to the canvas. And watching Iron Mike in action, one would assume in watching him that he is somewhat of a methodical competitor. Iron Mike. Again, keeping Fulton back to his feet. I mentioned, of course, he has been campaigning in the South, as I said earlier. And Mississippi and Louisiana in particular receive some tremendous accolades from those two states. And I'm beginning to see why now as Iron Mike begins to explode on this man, Charlie Fulton. Catches him again. A crashing forearm across the back of Charlie Fulton. Good high hip toss as Fulton back to the canvas. Another full body slam, and Fulton now has been slowed considerably. Fulton caught him in the midsection coming in. Caught him again. So, Fulton moved in to hang on. Now Fulton using that shoulder. And Iron Mike rolling out of the way just in time, catches Fulton. Brings him up. That was the pile driver. He hooks the far leg, utilizing that pile driver. Let me see if I can't. Well, we've got a little bit of a problem here. Let me see if I can't talk to this man, Iron Mike Sharp, for just a moment or two. In the meantime, time-wise, I'll be glad to talk to this gentleman. I'm sure that we can fill up some conversation. Perhaps we can get a standby match going here. We have several minutes left in the program, but first of all, may I congratulate you on quite an impressive win, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Sully, and I'm very glad this is my first appearance on Georgia Championship Wrestling, and I'm very impressed with some of the talent you have around here. I've heard about them. And I'm looking forward to getting in the ring with some of the top guys and seeing just how tough they are.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. In seeing you in action just now, I don't think anybody has to be convinced of your capabilities in the ring. I wonder if you'd, while we have a moment or two here, hopefully waiting for a standby match, I wonder if you'd mind, you are from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. I know you had quite an active background in high school and college.
Yes, I've been active in sports all my life. I played a great deal of football, amateur wrestling. I've done a lot of weightlifting. And I was quite deeply involved in boxing, both as an amateur and a professional. But I decided to make professional wrestling my career, and I'm looking forward to going right to the top in this business. And I think there's only one way you can do it is to get in there, give it all you have, and may the better man win.
Well, obviously, of course, we had one great Canadian, the Gene Kaninsky, who became world heavyweight champion. I would assume that that's the goal that you're seeking eventually.
I'd like nothing better. Nothing better. You know, Gene has been kind of an inspiration to me, and I'm looking forward to going right to the top just like he did.
Well, thank you so very, very much,
thank you very much.
Iron Mike Sharp, and easy, please. Thank you a lot, Iron Mike Sharp, and man has got a grip like iron, too, I'll tell you that right now.
Certainly one of the most popular young competitors to come down the pike in a long, long time has joined me, Tommy Wildfire Rich.